This is an experiment in how to turn blue plastic barrels like these, this big, you know, 3-4 foot high barrels, into something aesthetic by painting them. What's the best way to paint them? In my design, I'm looking at the easiest way to paint this chicken coop so it lasts 20, 30, 40 years comfortably. And I'm going to need to do some experimentation. This is a very rough mock-up. I painted this with gloss, and we're getting chips here now, scratch marks, and chips there. So that's after 6 months of use. So now I need to find a way to have a very robust paint effect on this that will last years. Here goes the experiment. I've cut up pieces of barrel as tester samples, and the reason why that gloss didn't stick to the glue, to the plastic, and just scraped off very easily was because I hadn't undercoated it, I hadn't primed it. Now, instead of a commercial primer, I've heard from a friend that using PVA glue is a very good primer. You paint it onto the plastic and then you put your paint onto the glue, once it's dry, of course. So I'm going to do an experiment with that and test them. They've all been painted, and this is after a night's drying. This is interior gloss, exterior gloss, interior eggshell, exterior undercoat, acrylic paint, Hammerite spray paint, Plasticote spray paint. These are all still tacky. They've not dried completely. That's completely dry. It dried in 15 minutes. And these are dry. They dry quite. That's still wet, the Hammerite actually. Still tacky. And it's a spray paint. Now, initial observations. First observation is I've sanded it too roughly. I used too rough a sandpaper. This plastic is so soft. So a light sand, because it's going to show up through the paint. Even with gloss paint, you can see it. The paint's not thick enough to cover over the irregularity. So lighter sandpaper next time. Next observation is quite significant. The difference between the coverage of PVA and non-PVA. I left this without the undercoat of PVA, and this is PVA'd. So that line indicates on each one of them where I've left a gap of PVA to see what the undercoat does. And the first observation is the undercoat helps coverage significantly. That's going to need two coats, one coat covers it. Same with the gloss here, a little bit patchy. This is okay, that's a little bit patchy. This is very patchy, and that's spray paint. And the spray paint says it doesn't need an undercoat, but it would certainly help it, and you'd save a lot of spray paint just by PVAing it. And that's the same amount of spray paint. It's strange. It's not like I've added extra or it's managed to take extra. It's an even spray across, and that's the effect. It's quite dramatic. Same with acrylic, so it would half the amount of cost. So initial observations, PVA base coat saves a lot of money, and who knows, through the test, we might find it actually makes the outer skin more robust as well. This is how I prepped the samples. I've just sanded them with, you can see the scratch marks, with a sandpaper, which is a P40 sandpaper, medium grade, and that'll be a key. I'm just going to rinse these off with the dirt and the sand, dust. Let them dry. That's them dried. And I've marked each with a line down here. PVA is going to cover this area and no PVA that area, just to see what difference the PVA makes. And numbered each in the corner. Painting the PVA on. I put the stripe the stuff on, use the brush, and that's the effect. 10-15 minutes later, that's them all painted. And this one's already going clear. So they'll all go completely clear eventually. 2 hours, it says. About an hour later,